What's up?
The most important mutation that triggers polycythemia is a mutation that causes formation of pathological JAK2 kinase that markedly increases the production of myeloid cells. Recall that on chromosome 9 located JAK2 gene that encodes JAK2 kinase. The function of JAK2 kinase is to activate cellular pathways that are responsible for cellular proliferation, mostly of myeloid cells, and the activation of pathways occurs by phosphorylation. By activation of JAK-STAT pathway, JAK2 kinase stimulates mostly red blood cells production. By activation of PI3K/AKT pathway, it stimulates the production of megakaryocytes from which platelets are formed. By activation of RAS pathway, it stimulates the production of granulocytes and monocytes. And in normal condition, JAK2 kinase is active only when it receives signal by cytokines. Kidneys produce erythropoietin that stimulates red blood cells production. Liver produces thrombopoietin that stimulates production of megakaryocytes from which platelets are formed. And bone marrow microenvironment by secretion of granulocyte macrophage colony stimulating factor causes increase in production of granulocytes and monocytes. But if mutation causes substitution of valine on phenylalanine in 617 position of JAK2 kinase, now JAK2 kinase becomes constantly activated, so this regulation by cytokines is gone, and this mutation causes disproportional activation of intracellular pathways that results in mild increase in granulocytes and monocytes, moderate increase in platelets, and severe increase in red blood cells.
Now what?
So, as a result of JAK2 kinase mutation, red blood cells increase the most. Also, it causes significant increase in megakaryocytes from which platelets are produced, so the amount of platelets in the blood also increase, and the amount of granulocytes and monocytes increase. Important that all of them are fully mature cells. To explain why mature cells are produced, we have to recall hematopoiesis. Hematopoiesis generally can be divided on myelopoiesis and lymphopoiesis. And myelopoiesis can be subdivided on erythropoiesis, from which red blood cells are produced, thrombopoiesis, where megakaryocytes are produced, and then from megakaryocytes platelets are formed, monocytopoiesis, where monocytes are produced, and finally granulopoiesis, where neutrophils, basophils, and eosinophils are produced. And when JAK2 kinase mutation occurs at a stage of stem cell or common myeloid progenitor cell, it simply increases the rate of production of myeloid cells. The production of red blood cells increases the most, also the production of megakaryocytes greatly increases, and in addition to this, the production of all other myeloid cells increases too. So, as in normal condition, all cells are produced. But such very fast rate of production is certainly pathological. And as we know, the overgrowth of three myeloid lineages, which are erythrocytes, thrombocytes, and granulocytes with monocytes, where red blood cells are the predominant form, is a characteristic feature of polycythemia. From these cells, increase in red blood cells causes the major clinical symptoms, which is logical because red blood cells increase the most.
Don't think about it.
But the most important cells in polycythemia progression are megakaryocytes. The reason is that inside the bone marrow, megakaryocytes produce profibrogenic factors, as platelet-derived growth factor and tumor-derived growth factor beta. And these factors stimulate fibroblasts to produce connective tissue as collagen inside the bone marrow. Why it's so dangerous? The problem is that bone marrow is already 100% fully packed with cells. It's erythroid cells, cells that belong to thrombocyte lineage, granulocytes with monocytes, and lymphoid cells. And when the amount of megakaryocytes increase, they substantially stimulate the production of connective tissue. We call this process bone marrow fibrogenesis. With increasing amount of fibrous tissue inside the bone marrow space decreases. And as we know, bone marrow is already 100% fully packed with cells. So decreasing bone marrow space forces cells to leave the bone marrow, so the amount of cells in the bone marrow decreases, And obviously, with decreasing amount of cells in the bone marrow, the amount of cells in the peripheral blood will decrease. This condition in polycythemia we call bone marrow fibrosis. So with increasing megakaryocytes, the amount of fibrous tissue increase, and with increasing amount of fibrous tissue, the space inside the bone marrow decrease. So normal cells forced to leave this crucial organ, so the production of blood cells progressively decrease, and thereby with time pancytopenia develops. Here we see in hematopoiesis that overproduction of megakaryocytes provoke increase in secretion of fibrogenic factors that actually cause bone marrow fibrosis. Statistically, polycythemia progressed to bone marrow fibrosis in 20-40% of cases in 10 years, and interesting that bone marrow fibrosis in polycythemia clinically has the same symptomatic as primary myelofibrosis. Another scenario is that with time another mutation can occur, and now this mutation will decrease the rate of cellular maturation. To explain this, in hematopoiesis we see that previously the mutation caused just increase in proliferation rate. But if the second mutation will disrupt cellular maturation, then it will be more and more harder for myeloblast to mature into red blood cell or megakaryocyte or segmented neutrophils, for example. So with second mutation, the amount of immature cells, including myeloblast, with time will progressively increase. And eventually, it will cause accumulation of blast cells in the bone marrow. The problem with blast cells is that they are large cells that take a lot of space and crowd out all other cells from the bone marrow. So, as we say, bone marrow is a space that is packed with cells. And in normal condition, bone marrow is 100% packed with cells in normal proportions. And in normal condition, myeloblasts take up only 2% from all space of the bone marrow. So other 98% of space is taken by all other cells. But now with mutation that disrupt maturation, the amount of blast cells increase and become 25%, for example. And because bone marrow is already fully packed with cells, so no vacant space here, with increase in blast, the space for all other cells decrease. So basically, blast cells crowd out normal cells from the bone marrow. So increase in very large blast cells force all other cells to leave the bone marrow, thereby it decreases the amount of erythroid cells, thromboid cells, granulocytes with monocytes, and lymphocytes. And eventually, this results in panmyelosis. So the second mutation causes accumulation of blast cells in the bone marrow that basically crowd out normal cells. And the state when the amount of blast cells become greater than 20% of all other cells in the bone marrow called acute leukemia. In this case, because myeloblasts accumulate, it will be called acute myeloid leukemia. And the transformation of polycythemia to acute myeloid leukemia occurs in 5-10% of all patients within 10 years.
Okay. Fine. Yep. Ciao!
What's that mean?
Ciao.
It's Italian. It means food.